All right, so in the last section, we spoke all about the distinction between vocal and instrumental music, and ultimately, the reason why vocal music is so much more popular is because vocal music, like all music, is a form of communication, and vocal music gives the perception or the feeling of a direct communication as opposed to instrumental music, where you feel like you're communicating through a medium. In other words, to use a crass analogy, and not to offend musicians, but the instrumental music is similar to having a conversation through an email or texting or even a telephone as opposed to vocal music where you're speaking to the person face to face. And this is powerful because communication is what creates intimacy. It's what creates relationships. You think about it, that's true. The more you talk to somebody, the more you get to know that person, the closer you feel to that person. And that's the way it works. Let's just go a little bit deeper with this and show how it ultimately leads to the spiritual experience. And then we can try to tie up the loose ends and show really the spiritual experience in music, at least part one, introduction part one. This happens to be part two of our series, but we're in part one of the greater picture. Anyways, so you'll find, if you ever go to a lecture, let's say, it's some boring lecture about some boring topic, and the guy is standing up in the front of the room, and he's speaking for about an hour. And he's speaking to 300 people in the hall, let's say. You sit there, you listen, the guy's communicating to you, you feel like you know him, especially he tells a few personal stories, or he presses a button or scratches a nerve or something, he gets under your skin a little bit, you feel like you know him, you're comfortable, even though you have no idea who this guy is, he has no idea who you are, you didn't meet beforehand, but still, after listening to the guy speak for an hour, you feel comfortable to go up and introduce yourself, to talk, you might even tell a personal story. Happens all the time. Take it a step further with music. When you listen to music, you feel like you get to know the band, you feel like you're a member of the family, you feel like you know them. I'll give you a story. I remember when I was a kid, I was in summer camp. I was probably 10, 11 years old. And I was in my bunk in camp, and there's another kid in my bunk. His name was John Kleinstein. John, if you're listening, what's happening? Anyway, so John was really into the Beatles. Like, he loved the Beatles. And he got me, like, turned on them. It got me just, I got hooked. So that whole summer, I'm listening to John's Beatle collection. I'm into the Beatles. I get home, I just start buying Beatles albums, like they're going out of style. I got the Red Album and the Blue One. Those are those greatest hits albums. They're actually really cool. The Blue One, I know, had blue vinyl. I think the Red One had red vinyl originally too, but mine had black, but whatever. I listened to it so much, I wore out the grooves. One of my friends, he gave me blank tapes, maybe made copies for him. Anyways, I listened to the Beatles constantly, and I got totally into them, and I felt like I knew them. I would read some articles, I'd look at pictures, I'd analyze the albums, I'd think about the lyrics. I felt like the Beatles were my friends to the extent that when I was talking to my friends about the Beatles and about their music, I would call them by their first name. It's like, you know, I love the way Paul sings on Helter Skelter. I am so digging George right now on The End, you know? And I remember when, you know, when John Lennon was killed, and I was bummed. And I wasn't alone. There were millions of people who were really bummed when John Lennon was killed, because we felt like we knew him. The Beatles were our friends. Now, we weren't disturbed. We weren't psychologically imbalanced. Most of us realized that the Beatles weren't our friends. We didn't really know John Lennon, but still, it was powerful. A lot of people were really upset. A lot of people cried. I remember driving to an ice skating rink with my parents, and we were in the radio, and the radio did a moment of silence. All these rock stations around the country had a moment of silence for John Lennon. I remember I sat there, and I was silent for a minute in the car. It was like, it affected us because you feel like you know the band. That's the thing. You listen, the musician is communicating with you. It's creating this sense of closest connection. You feel like you're friends. Me and the Beatles, we're best friends. It works the opposite way as well. When you're communicating and speaking to someone else, you feel the sense of closeness and connection to him or her. Also, for example, when you see a singer or someone in a band, they're up on stage. You ever see this? The singer goes, "I love you all." And you're thinking to yourself, "Ah, you phony showbiz celebrity goon, you know, whatever." You should give the guy a break. He probably really means it because he's standing on stage. You say, "I love you all." It's just like, I just sang to you for an hour. I communicated to you with you for an hour. I just poured my guts out and I'm hearing the applause and I'm seeing that you're reciprocating. I feel a sense of connection. We have a relationship. It's an incredible thing. Communication builds relationships. And even in this anonymous environment of musicians and audience or even just speakers and audience, it breaks down these walls. We feel a sense of closeness and connection. When you do the communicating, like I said, it makes you feel even closer. And that's why, I'll tell you, actually, I was speaking with a headhunter once. The guy's job it was to get people jobs. And he said, the secret to a successful job interview is totally counterintuitive. People think you got to go in there, you have to know your resume cold, you have to speak well, say good things, wear the right clothes. None of that stuff means anything. You go in there and you talk your head off, You're boring. The secret to a successful job interview is to get the person doing the interviewing to do all the talking, because he sits there, he talks and communicates, and he feels good, and he identifies you with those good feelings. You're much more likely to get the job than the person with the perfect resume who couldn't shut up. That's how these things work. Anyways, this take this a step further when you get into the spiritual experience. If you're there, whether you're sitting around a campfire with a group of friends, or you're meditating in the woods, or even in a more formal religious setting, and you start singing, you feel the sense of closeness. You're developing a sense of relationship with whatever spiritual source it is that you're communicating with. And it's real. And if you think about it also, this is a deep idea we'll explore in a later time, but relationships and spirituality really come from the same place. They tickle the same pleasure sensors. They do the same kind of things. When you're longing for a relationship, use words like longing and yearning. When you're searching and struggling for spirituality, use the same things. You're longing and yearning for a spiritual experience. And when you find it, you feel connected. When you're in love and a good relationship, you feel connected. It's the same type of experience. So it's no surprise that when you go through an experience and you communicate, like through music in particular, using this language of music, and you communicate, you feel the sense of closeness, you feel a sense of closeness with other people. It enhances the spiritual experience as well, if not creates a spiritual experience, because you're going through this process of communicating and feeling the sense of connection. We're going to take a short break. When we come back, we'll sum it all up, talking about how in the spiritual setting, the sense of communication, the sense of relationship that it creates, and even further, how it rubs off on the people around you.